Please subscribe my channel and press the bell icon for getting latest updated video. Hello friends, my name is Bhavesh Parmar. In previous session we have started the lesson instruction set and programming of 8085, and we also discussed how this lesson is so important from our point of view, because guys, in paper second, if we see the weightage, its weightage is approximately 43 marks with option. And also guys, we have to perform so many practicals related with this lesson. So in this lesson we are going to study a new programming language, that is assembly language, which is supported by 8085 microprocessor. So we are going to write down so many small and big programs, and also some of the programs ask in HSC board examination for writing point of view. So guys, in previous session we have discussed what do you mean by flag registers, different types of registers. So in that registers we have seen general purpose registers, special purpose registers, how they are going to store 8-bit data, how it is beneficial by using these in register pair to store 16-bit address. Thereafter, we have also discussed special purpose registers. So these special purpose registers are used by microprocessor during execution of program, assembly language program, and all these registers are specially 16-bit. So there are total three special types of special purpose register, that is SP means stack pointer, PC that is program counter, and incrementer and decrementer. Is that clear guys? And 9 different general purpose registers are there, that is temporary register, PSW, it is also called program status word, then accumulator, register B, register C, D, E and HL registers. So these are the 9 different general purpose registers. They are widely used to store 8-bit data, and microprocessor also provides us 3 different register pairs, and these register pairs are register pair BC, DE as well as HL. So what is the main use of this register pair? So by using this register pair, we can store a 16-bit address within it. Is that clear guys? Thereafter, we have studied what do you mean by instruction. So instruction is nothing but what? These are the special symbol, and every instruction consists of opcode as well as operand. Is that clear? And opcode means what? Operation code which is to be performed, and on whom we are going to perform, it is called operand. So specially operands means there are 3 different types of operand, whether we are going to perform operation on either on register, either directly on data, or on 16-bit address. Okay, and these instructions are classified into 3 different types, that is 1-byte instruction, 2-byte instruction and 3-byte instruction. So how can we identify whether it is 1-byte instruction? So generally, if any instruction consists of operation which is to be performed on register. So which are these registers? That is either A, B, C, D, E, H, L. So in that case, if operation carried out on this register, then we say that it is called 1-byte instruction. That is opcode and operand both are stored within the same byte. And what do you mean by 2-byte instruction? So in case of 2-byte instruction, opcode as well as operand both are stored in separate byte. So in specially, it is very easy to identify whether it is a 2-byte instruction. So how can we identify? Note that guys, if there is an operation carried out on 8-bit data, that is 2-digit number, hexadecimal number is given and opcode is given, then we directly say that it is a 2-byte instruction. Okay, and how can we identify whether it is a 3-byte instruction? So guys, if operation carried out on 16-bit address, in that case it is called 3-byte instruction, that is opcode stored in 1 byte and 2 bytes are reserved for operand. Okay, and that operand consists of what? 16-bit hexadecimal number, that is 4-digit number, and first 2 digits are called higher order 8-bit data, that is called MSB data. And remaining 2 digits are called lower order 8-bit data, which is represented by LSB. But guys, whenever we are going to store in byte format, that is byte 1, byte 2, byte 3. So specially what happened in case of byte 1, we are going to store opcode. And in byte 2, we are going to store lower order 8-bit data. And in third memory block, we are going to store higher order 8-bit data. So this is quite twist, but you have to remember it. First of all, you have to store lower order data, then we are going to store higher order data. So in this fashion, we can identify it is 1-byte instruction, 2-byte instruction and 3-byte instruction.
So again, I'm going to tell you why I'm going to tell you these things again and again. Guys, because we have to write down the instructions. And in instructions, they are just give you write down the following instructions with suitable example. So you should at least eligible to identify whether that instruction is either 1-byte instruction, 2-byte instruction or 3-byte instruction. Most of the students, they fail to identify the number of bytes and which results into loss of marks. So guys, we don't want to lose not our single half mark also in that instruction. Okay, so how can we identify 1-byte instruction? If operation carried out on register, then it is called 1-byte instruction. If operation carried out on 8-bit data, then it is called 2-byte instruction. And if operation carried out on address, that is 16-bit number, so in that case especially it is called 3-byte instruction. So guys, in today's session we are going to discuss a very important 4 marks question, and the name of question is addressing mode. So generally they are asked question in our examination, what is addressing mode and how many addressing mode supported by 8085 microprocessor. Explain these addressing mode with suitable example. So guys, first of all, addressing mode means what? It is a method to access the data directly or indirectly. So why we are going to access the data or why we are going to fetch the data? Because we are going to perform so many operations on that given data. So it is nothing but called what? Addressing mode. It is a method to access or to retrieve the data directly or indirectly. So it is called addressing mode. And why we are going to access that data? Only and only to perform operations. Is that clear, guys? So there are 5 different addressing mode. Okay, so 5 addressing mode are there. And guys, whenever we are going to write down 7 points related with our normal instruction, so in that one of the point is related with addressing mode. And there is always one question asked in your question paper related with addressing mode. So that's why guys, you just try to understand this concept. Still, if you are difficult to find out understanding the concept, I request you to see this video again and again. So that's why it will more and more easily clear to you. But guys, without understanding bytes, without understanding flags, addressing mode, you can't write not a single instruction. It is very difficult to remember because guys, we have so many instructions we need to study and it is difficult to remember these many instructions. So we cannot learn also. Is that clear? It is pure a mutual understanding lesson. Is that clear, guys? So once if you get all these instructions clearly, then and only then we are eligible to write down assembly language programs. Okay guys, so there are 5 different addressing mode provided by 8085 microprocessor. So which are these? So first addressing mode is called direct addressing mode. I'm just going to write down in short addressing mode. Then second one is called register addressing mode. Thereafter, third one is called register indirect addressing mode. Then fourth is called immediate addressing mode. And at the end, finally, fifth addressing mode is called implicit addressing mode. So these are the total new words which is you have heard first time in your computer science career. So guys, there is nothing to be worried. We are going to study these addressing mode one by one with simple example. How can we remember these addressing mode? This trick I will also going to tell you. So what is your job? You have to try to understand all these addressing mode very carefully. But before that guys, I am again telling you, first of all, you have idea to identify whether it is 1-byte instruction, 2-byte instruction or 3-byte instruction. First of all, that concept should be very clear to you. Then and only then, you just try to understand these addressing mode. And once if you got the concept related with addressing mode, then and only then we are just eligible to write down the instructions. So it is more easier. Okay guys, so let me start our first addressing mode, and the name of addressing mode is what? Direct addressing mode. So guys, how can we identify whether the given instruction belongs to direct addressing mode? So guys, in that case, it is very easy to understand, very easy to remember. So generally we know that a normal particular instruction consists of opcode as well as operand. Okay, so in case of direct addressing mode, a 16-bit address is given in the instruction. Means there is no any intermediate register is appear in the instruction. Means after opcode, address is visible. Is that clear? So in that case, it is called what? Direct addressing mode instruction. So I will explain you with example, and you also kindly note that whenever we are going to write down the explanation in HSC board paper, so without forget, you just write down the example. Because if you are not going to write down the example, unnecessary your marks get cut. Okay, so let me see the example. So suppose here I am going to write down content of A is equal to 05H. So how to read this? Content of A is 05H. And then here I am going to write down, suppose this 2000 is nothing but what? It is an address. An address consists of what? 16-bit address. And content of address means what? Value stored at particular address. So generally content of A means what? Value stored at register A. So what is the value? 05H. Content of 2000 means what? Value stored at particular address. And here suppose here I am going to write down suppose 77. So 77 is nothing but what? Value. This value stored at particular address, that is content of 2000 is equal to 77H. Is that clear? Now guys, thereafter I am going to write down the instruction. Suppose here I am write down LDA 2000H. So LDA 2000H means what? So now at this level, at this stage, you don't have any idea regarding about not a single instruction. But guys, whenever you are quite familiar with instructions, then and only then you are going to write down the different types of example. But at this stage, what is your job? You just try to understand the example. So this is what instruction. So this is LDA is nothing but what? It is my opcode. So after opcode, there is no any special register is mentioned here. Directly address is there. And we know that if there is a 4-digit number, means it is nothing but 16-bit address is there, and we can directly say that it is a 3-byte instruction. So why it is 3-byte instruction? Because 1 byte is reserved for opcode and 2 bytes are reserved for operand. That is what? 16-bit address. So what do you mean by LDA? Load accumulator direct from this memory location. So what is 2000? 2000 is nothing but my 16-bit address. And what is the value stored at 2000? So we say that content of 2000 is equal to what? 77H. So that 77H data we are going to move to A. A means what? Accumulator. So after executing this instruction by computer, what is the value of A now? So value of A gets overwrite, means 05 is my old value. So it is replaced by new value 77H. And what will be the effect on content of 2000 is equal to 77H? It remains as it is. Got it guys? So how can we explain direct addressing mode? Means in given instruction, 16-bit address is there. And 16-bit address is there. We say that directly it is a 3-byte instruction. And after opcode, direct address is there. So that's why it is called direct addressing mode instruction. So this is the basic example regarding with direct addressing mode. Okay guys, so I am repeating again and again to you, in first look, in first view of this video, there might be a difficulty to understand these addressing mode. So what I am trying to request you see this video again and again and again, So that's why once if you get the register addressing mode, direct addressing mode, all these addressing mode clear to you, then and only then you are eligible to write down the instructions. So that's why, guys, I'm telling you again and again to you. Is that clear, guys? So according to that, you should try to understand how the importance of this topic. Okay, so this is our first addressing mode. Now, guys, we are going to switch on to our second addressing mode. And what is the name of our second addressing mode? Register addressing mode. So how can we identify whether the given instruction belongs to register addressing mode? So in register addressing mode, there are specially operation carried out on registers only. So which registers are there? A, B, C, D, E, H, L. So these are the special 8 registers are there, and specially these registers are used to store 8-bit data, and some registers are used in pair to store 16-bit address. Got it, guys? So in simple language, what you are going to understand, what you are going to remember, if operation carried out on registers only, then it is called register addressing mode. Means, no, this type of address is visible. No, this kind of data is visible. So that's why we can free to say that it is 1-byte instruction. Okay, so direct addressing mode belongs to 3-byte instruction. Why? Because this address is directly appears in the instruction. But in case of register addressing mode, operation carried out only and only on registers. Okay, so let me see the example related with this register addressing mode. So suppose I am going to take content of A is equal to 05H. Here I am going to write down content of B is equal to 07H. And here I am going to write down the example MOV A, B. Okay, so this is my instruction. MOV is nothing but what? It is opcode. And this opcode we are going to perform on whom? A and B. So A and B are nothing but what? These are the 8-bit general purpose register. And what is the role of these registers? So these registers are useful to store 8-bit data. Is that clear? MOV A, B means what? Value of B copied into value of A. So what it means, after executing this instruction, what is the output? Content of A is equal to 07H. And what is content of B? So it is unchanged, that is 07H. We are moving the data from source to destination. So if you see this kind of register, means not only A, B, suppose if you are going to see in any example B, C, D, E, H, L, any kind of example registers in the example, then you directly say that it is 1-byte register addressing mode instruction. Got it, guys? So this is our second addressing mode. Now we are going to move our third addressing mode, and the name of addressing mode is register indirect addressing mode. Okay, so before starting that addressing mode, let me take our first two addressing mode review, that is direct addressing mode. So how can we identify? So if 16-bit address appears in the instruction directly after opcode, then it is called 3-byte direct addressing mode instruction. And if operation carried out on registers only, then we say that register addressing mode with 1-byte instruction. Okay, so now we are going to focus on our third addressing mode, that is called register indirect addressing mode. So guys, as the name suggests, register indirect addressing mode means indirect means what? In that case, we are operating on register pair. So how many registers pair provided by microprocessor? So there are 3 register pair. So which are these register pair? So these register pairs are BC, DE and HL. So these 3 registers pair specially provided by microprocessor. And I already told you in previous session, HL is also called M. M represents memory. So specially these 3 register pairs are used. And what is the role of register pair? Register pairs are helps to store 16-bit address. Okay. Now, guys, in case of register indirect addressing mode, what happen? We are going to perform operation on register pair only. So if register pair is appear in my instruction, so we directly say that it is belongs to register indirect addressing mode, and it is also a 1 byte instruction. So why is it, guys, 1 byte instruction? I will show you with example. So that's why it is more clear and more easier to you, and why it is indirect mode. Okay, so in register addressing mode, we see that directly registers are there, so we can directly handle with, or we can directly play with these registers. So we can moving the data, we can adding the data. So many operations we are going to be perform. Now see how register indirect addressing mode example works. So let me take the example. Suppose here I am going to write down content of A is equal to suppose 55H, and suppose I am going to use one address is there. So what is that address? Content of 2000. What is the value of content of 2000? 22H. So below that, suppose here I am going to write down content of HL is equal to 2000H. So what do you mean by this statement? So HL is nothing but what? It is a register pair. So in that register pair, what I am going to store? I am going to store a 16 bit address. Note that, guys, ordinary variable can store only and only 8 bit data. But whenever I work with register pair, so it specially stores 16 bit address. Got it, guys? So I already told you HL is also called what? M. M represents memory. So it is widely used by microprocessor, even though user can also use it to write down the various program. So let me see the example. Here I am going to write down suppose MOV A comma M. Is that clear? And we know that A is nothing but what? A is our register, general purpose 8-bit register, and it has capability to store only and only 8-bit data. Okay, MOV A comma M. M means what, guys? I already told you it is register pair HL. Is that clear? So what happened? From memory, the data is shifted to register A. So M represents what? HL. HL consists of what? 2000. So is it possible to move this 2000 in A? No, guys. Why? Because it is an address and it is an ordinary 8-bit register. So it can store only 8-bit data. So what it means, move A comma M? So content of HL, that is 2000, and its content, that is content of HL. Look at, guys, what I'm trying to say. Content of HL means what? Address. And its content of address, that is called content of memory. See, guys, content of HL is nothing but what? 2000H. And what is the content of 2000H? It is my data. And what is that data? 22. So that 22 data I am going to move in register A. So after executing this instruction, what is the output? Content of A becomes 22H, means previous value of, that is 55, gets overwrite. Got it, guys? So that's why it is called register indirect. Means what happened? In that case, we are going to use register pair. Register pair specially store some address, and on that particular address, some value gets stored. So means we are accessing this value indirectly. Okay, guys, so that's why it is called register indirect addressing mode. Okay, guys, so this is our third addressing mode. So first of all, we discussed direct addressing mode, then register addressing mode, register indirect addressing mode. So I repeat you again, how can we remember register indirect addressing mode? If operation carried out on any register pair, so which are these register pair? B, C, D, E, H, L. So if you see that any one of them in the instruction, then you are free to say that register indirect addressing mode instruction is there. Got it, guys? Okay, and it is always a 1 byte instruction. Why it is 1 byte instruction? If you see this instruction carefully, no 8-bit data is present, no 4-digit number, that is 16-bit address is there. So that's why it is 1 byte instruction. Okay, guys. Now we are going to focus our second last addressing mode, and the name of addressing mode is immediate addressing mode. Okay, so generally, guys, immediate addressing mode, either it is 2-byte instruction or it can be either 3-byte instruction. So why I'm saying like this? Because if we are going to perform any operation on 8-bit data, then it is called, in that case, 2-byte instruction. But suppose if I'm going to perform operation on 16-bit address, then in that case, we say that it is 3-byte instruction. Okay, so how to remember immediate addressing mode instruction? I will show you the trick. Okay. So first of all, we discussed immediate addressing mode for 2-byte instruction. So how can we say that? If in given instruction, if 8-bit data appears immediately after the instruction, then it is called 8-bit immediate addressing mode. Okay, so I will show you the example. Suppose here I am going to write down, suppose content of A is equal to suppose 00H. And suppose here I am going to write down the instruction directly, MVI A, 99H. So what do you mean by this instruction? Move immediate. Move immediate. What do you have to move? This 99 value in register A. So what happened? After executing this instruction, what is my output? Content of A is equal to 99H. Means previously, what is its value? 00H. So it is replaced by 99. So it is called what? 8-bit immediate addressing mode instruction. So why it is 8-bit immediate addressing mode? Because this 8-bit data is there, and this 8-bit number appears after instruction. Okay. And for simple point of view, if your instruction is end with I, then we say that it is immediate addressing mode. I will tell you some different example also. SUI, then SBI, ADI. Okay, so there are so many examples related with immediate addressing mode, and these are nothing but what? Instructions. So these instructions we are going to study in depth. Is that clear, guys? So don't worry about it. So you have to just remember, if 2-digit number appears and if I is end or I is the last character of that instruction, so we directly say that with confidence it is immediate addressing mode. And how many bytes it related with? It is 2-byte instruction. So as I told you before starting this immediate addressing mode, it can be either 2-byte or 3-byte instruction. So here we are going to discuss the example of 2-byte instruction related to immediate addressing mode. Now guys, we are going to focus immediate addressing mode with 3-byte instruction. Okay. So suppose here I'm going to write down content of 2000 is equal to suppose 55H, and suppose here I'm going to write down A is equal to suppose 99H. So this is the basic example. You can take any kind of example. You are totally free. So there is no any compulsion. Whatever the example I have used, you also need to write down, or it is also compulsory to use the same example in your examination. No, guys. You can write down, you're totally free. You can use your own example also. Okay. So guys, let me see the example. Suppose here I'm going to write down LXI H, 2000H. LXI H, 2000H. So guys, if you observe this, the last character of that instruction is I. So we can directly say that it is immediate addressing mode instruction. But now guys, how can we identify whether it is 2-byte or 3-byte? So guys, in this instruction, this 4-digit number appears. And we know that if 4-digit number appears, it is definitely a 16-bit address. So that's why we are directly free to say that it is immediate addressing mode instruction with 3-bytes. Is that clear, guys? So it is more easily clear to you. How can you identify immediate addressing mode with 2-byte instruction and 3-byte instruction? So I tell you in short and simple way, if operation carried out on data, then it is 2-byte instruction. If operation carried out on address, then it is 3-byte instruction. Okay, and if nothing is given in the instruction, means no data, no address is there or not visible, then we are free to say that it is 1 byte instruction. Got it, guys? Now we are going to focus on our last addressing mode. And what is the name of that addressing mode? Implied addressing mode or implicit addressing mode. Okay. So how can we identify whether it is implied or implicit addressing mode? That I am also going to tell you its trick, so it is easy to remember. Okay, generally what happens, guys, we see that a normal particular instruction consists of opcode as well as operand. So we can directly access directly or indirectly, or we can access the data through registers also. But what happens in case of implied implicit addressing mode? This type of instruction consists of only and only opcode, means no operand is visible, or you can say that it is hidden. Is that clear? So that's why it is called what? Implied oblique implicit addressing mode. So I will show you some example. Say for example CMA or HLT, NOP, then RAR. So there are so many examples are there. So you can write down any one example. Suppose let me take the first example, RAR. So this is nothing but what? My instruction. Means opcode is there, but on whom we are going to perform the operation, it is not visible. Or you can say that it is invisible or hidden. So suppose if you see this type of instruction in your question paper, you are directly say that these instruction belongs to what? Implied oblique implicit addressing mode. And we know that in this instruction, no data is visible, no address is visible. So we directly say that it is 1 byte instruction. Got it, guys? So in this way, we have discussed all 5 addressing mode. And I'm repeating again to you, guys, once if you get the idea to understand how to identify addressing mode with bytes, then and only then you are eligible to write various instruction. Otherwise, you cannot write it. It is very difficult. Is that clear? So let me take the revision of again implied implicit addressing mode. In implied implicit addressing mode, opcode is appear, but operand is invisible. Or you can say that it is hidden. So that's why it is say that implied oblique implicit addressing mode. And this type of addressing mode consists of 1 byte instruction. Okay, so let me take the review of all our 5 different addressing modes. So which is our first addressing mode? Direct addressing mode. So in direct addressing mode, after opcode, address is appear. So that's why it is called direct addressing mode, and it is 3 byte instruction. Then we discussed register addressing mode. So in register addressing mode, specially operation carried out on registers only, general purpose registers. So which are these registers? A, B, C, D, E, H, L. So if we are going to perform operation on any one of the register, then we directly say that it is register addressing mode, and it is also a 1 byte instruction. Thereafter, we discussed register indirect addressing mode. So how can we identify that? If operation carried out on any 16 bit register address is there, and if we use register pair in the instruction, then and only they say that it is register indirect addressing mode. Or in short, in simple language, if operation carried out on register pair, we directly say that it is register indirect addressing mode, and it is also 1 byte instruction. Okay, thereafter we discuss second last instruction addressing mode, immediate addressing mode. So in case of immediate addressing mode, if data is visible after immediately opcode, then it is called immediate addressing mode instruction, and it belongs to 2 byte. Why? Because we are operating on data. And if instead of data, if address is there, then we say that immediate addressing mode with 3 byte instruction. Okay. And at the end, implied oblique implicit addressing mode, how can we identify? So if opcode is appear but operand is not appear, means you can say that it is hidden or invisible. So in that, say that we can directly say that it is implied oblique implicit addressing mode instruction. It is also a 1 byte instruction. Got it, guys? So after clearing all these concepts, we are going to start our actual instruction part, and we have to study 5 different groups of instruction. So which are these instruction groups are there? So first of all, we have to discuss data transfer group, then arithmetic group, logical group, then branching group, and at the end, fifth and final is machine control group instructions. So if we see that all the groups, these groups consist of different instructions, we have to just try to familiar with these groups and related instructions. So that's why we can easily understand these instructions, and that will definitely helps you to write down small and simple assembly language programs. So guys, in next session we are going to discuss how to write down the instruction. So I also told you, for single instruction we need to write down approximately 7 points. So which are these 7 points, we are going to discuss in detail in our next session. So guys, thanks for watching this video. Stay safe, stay home. Thank you.